What's up, guys? Welcome back to Golf Simulator Videos. We're here today with the UNEEKORE IXO. All right, that's the ceiling mounted overhead high-speed camera infrared based golf launch monitor. It has two high-speed cameras and it actually uses balls with no markings, okay, and also has advanced club data. We've been showing it significantly in the channel. Today we're here to show you guys a big software update that UNEEKORE has released for their View software, which is the base software that's included when you purchase a UNEEKORE launch monitor. What I like about UNEEKORE is that they're always listening to their users, always trying to come out with enhancements or any type of, you know, changes to the software that gives a better experience or may provide more things to the user. Today, that's going to be with the View software. I think you're going to be really impressed with what I have to show you, okay? So one, really quick before we get started, if you guys haven't had a chance to subscribe yet, please do. I appreciate it. Like the video, comment below any questions that you have or what you think about this recent update, any updates that you'd like to see. I'd be more than happy to pass it on to UNEEKORE. All right. And then as always, if you're looking to purchase a UNEEKORE QED or IXO, make sure you shoot me an email. All right. I'll pin it to the top of the comments and in the description. And then also, if you're looking for a whole package, my partners have access to everything, wholesale access to screens and projectors and turf, you name it, can do everything from a basic garage build to all the way to a luxury custom build out. All right, so make sure you shoot me an email. Love saving my viewers the most amount of money. Make sure you're getting what you need. All right, so let's talk about my setup today really quick, because it's going to be important with these updates that are coming out. So I actually have three different monitors, if you will, going on. One is the projector, which is my latest install. That's the BenQ LU935ST. All right, that's a 16 by 10 native resolution or format. All right, the resolution would be 1920 by 1200. All right, versus a normal 1080p is 1920 by 1080. So that 1200 makes it a taller image. All right, I like it. It's very immersive. When you don't have a super wide space, my room's only 15 feet wide, that nice tall, all right, screen really makes a difference. All right, it's a full 8 feet tall and it's 12 and a half feet wide. All right, and then I have a 4K monitor. It's a 27 inch monitor that's connected to my desktop, and then up top that you'll see in a minute, I'm going to show you guys all this in a separate video. You're going to see a large, I think it's a 50 inch LED TV up top. All right, so let's head over to the View software so I can show you guys kind of the first couple things that are updated, and then we're going to give you guys a demonstration of how to use it all. All right, so as I walk over here to the desktop, the first thing I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna go ahead and take down my camera. All right, this is going to give you guys the ability to see the entire View software that I need to show you the updates on. Okay, so here we are with the normal software homepage, if you will, that you guys are used to seeing. So many of you are in offset environments, and if you're using this screen right here, you've asked to have an offset image, okay? Well, check this out. It's as easy as hitting the control button and the right or left arrow. You do have to be on the front view and on this image, okay? And then obviously clicked on the software. But if I hit the right button, all right, or the left button, I can now adjust my offset. And if you wanted to go really far, you can go really far, all right? It completely offsets that. That way, when you're hitting the ball, it's actually taking off from dead center. Okay, so I think that's really cool, something for you guys to get excited about if you're in an offset environment. But here's where things get really awesome, all right? So if you go down the lower left here and you see this little square with the arrow pointing up to the upper right, I'm gonna click on that. That's going to give you a SubView, all right? This SubView is very powerful. Those that have multiple monitors, you're going to be able to select between this view, which can either have data at the bottom or not. You can see that show and hide button up on top, all right? The club data view, the 2D trajectory over top and apex, side view, or tons of data tiles. Now you can open up four different windows. So if you have like three TVs on your wall, I mean, you could litter your golf simulator with data, all right, to display on all these different monitors. And when you're in a coaching or teaching environment, I think it's gonna be very, very useful. So this is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna take this first image and I'm going to drag it over here to my projector. Now what I'll do is I'll take my camera and I'll put it back up so you guys can see. Here I am on my projector image. If I had that data on the bottom, that's what it would look like. And then if at any point in time I wanted to look at any different data from this view, I could. But as you can see, I really like that it's a full immersive experience, okay? So what I now wanna do is I'm just going to shrink down my camera a little bit so it's not blocking too much. You guys will still be able to see inside. And then I'm going to open up one more window, all right? And I'm going to do the club view. All right, and then I'll take that, and I actually like the photo view. I'm gonna take that and I'll bring it up top, and I actually have iron selected right now. It will show a wood until you hit your first shot. And then I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to grab my glove and I'm gonna take a quick shot. That way we have data as a demonstration, and I'll show you guys how powerful this is when you can, you know, actually have multiple monitors going on and what you can see. All right, just a nice little draw down there. All right, perfect. Didn't even expect it to be that good, but a little nine iron right down the middle. All right, and then now what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to grab my phone and I will start a video really quick. There we go. And I'm actually gonna walk backwards and I'm gonna show you guys my entire studio. So you guys have seen this before. This is the entire studio. I have my projector over here on the left. That's that 16 by 10 image. What I love is that it's just huge. I mean, super immersive. If you needed to offset that at all, you can take that line now and just move it right or left if you're in an offset environment. That's what's so nice, okay? And then if you go over here, here's this 4K main desktop monitor that I have going on. And if I wanted to, I could be looking at my side or top view. I could be looking at my grouping, my club, even your swing, all right? So I could be actually going to replay right here. I actually have my web camera hooked up. I could be looking at my swing on this monitor. Then check this out. Then up on the TV, I could just be glancing over every time looking at the impact. I had a little bit of a draw. You can see that club face is just a little bit closed. Let's say we wanted to replay the video. There it is. And then just so you guys know, after you take a shot, it actually automatically replays that video. So you could just glance over. Now, I don't have my club stickered up right now, but if you wanted to, you would have your club data and everything up there. So I think this is just a perfect example of how you could have all of this data just, you know, on any type of monitor that you want. Let's say that you are doing instruction or coaching and you want to just, you know, throw up on the big screen really quick that club data that we were just looking at. Well, there it is. I mean, now it's up on your giant projector. I mean, let's just go up really quick. Look how big that is. And you can just, you know, flip back and forth. I love how you can, look at, you can read titles so perfectly. Actually, there's a mark on the ball you can see. And then let's say you wanted to look at trajectories. Let's say you wanted to blow up all the data points. There's all the data points. So you could be a coach or an instructor and you could be easily throwing this up, not only on multiple TVs on a wall, but just clicking back and forth so easily on your projector. Now I'm gonna go ahead and stop this video. All right, perfect. And then I'm going to go back. I'm gonna close this window. We'll go back to the main screen really quick and I'll just bring that up. And I'll come over here because I just wanna wrap up with a few really important points for you guys. So understand that, you know, you can do this on however number of monitors that you want. So you saw my TV up there on the wall. If you wanted to add two more TVs, you could. You could have data on one. You could have club data on the other. You might even have something different on another one, and you could all have all those outputs coming from your desktop, okay? So the other thing to understand is that, you know, if you're a coach and you're looking to control the software from the main screen, it's really easy to do. You can leave that main screen up there. But if for some reason that you want to duplicate two of your monitors, that way they're the same from your desktop to your main screen, you could do that. My desktop that I showed you guys could be duplicated to this pop-out. And then I could have that main screen on another screen if I wanted to. So just understand that there's, you know, various capabilities that you could go through there and switch it out to any way you want. I love how you can just hide and show that data at the bottom. Another update for you guys to notice is that the apex and total is now showing on this pop-out window. I think that's really nice. It's some quick, easy feedback, because then I don't have to have the data popped up if I'm just working on carry distances, or I want to kind of just give a good idea of the apex that I flight that ball a little bit higher. You know, it's just really easy to do. So I hope this is kind of a good overview of this update. I'm going to dive in more personally myself. I didn't have my swing optics system plugged in today, but just so you guys understand, I showed you that how easy it was just to kind of go in that web camera view and look at my web camera. That's something that you may want that main screen up on a TV and blow it up. You may want to bring that over to your main screen, and you could have this on a different monitor. The possibilities are really endless, because you can open up as many as you want just by clicking down there. And I should say, not as many as you want, up to 4, I believe, is what it supports in the SubView. But I mean, like I said before, you'd be littering your studio with data at that stage. But really important, just want to make sure you guys understand, if you have any questions or comments or anything you'd like to ask, make sure you put those down below. I'd love to hear your feedback, not only on this update, but what other updates you'd like to see. Like I said before, I'd love you guys to leave those below. And as always, if you or anyone you know is looking to purchase a UNEEKORE system, I'd love to assist. Shoot me an email. I'm always here to help. It's really exciting seeing, you know, more updates, you know, come out. And I'll always make sure to keep you guys up to date on all of that. So stay tuned, and we'll talk to you soon.